can you give us the implementation plans for the green lane?
Yeah, we're actually we just proposed this last Thursday with the IATF because a lot of our, let's say, balikbayans are already fully vaccinated. Right now, we are allowing balikbayans to come to the Philippines. They are our third largest market. But because they have to quarantine for 10 days, they are discouraged to come. 10 days in the hotel, and of course, another 4 days at home. But then the protocols for fully vaccinated and non-vaccinated are the same. So we propose to the IATF, if it's possible, to maybe have a different protocol for fully vaccinated individuals. We've been monitoring other Asian countries. Like, for example, in Thailand, if you are fully vaccinated, your quarantine days are shortened from 10 days to 7 days.
Okay.
So that's what we're still proposing, that at least shorter quarantine days to encourage them naman to come home.
Okay. And in your new proposal, if a person, hypothetically, let's say has been fully vaccinated coming from the States, no? So usually that's either Pfizer or Moderna. Mm-hmm. It is possible kasi they can be a carrier, right?
Yes.
But you are vaccinated. Hindi nangangahulugan na magkakasakit ka.
Correct.
So what is the testing period that you are proposing when they arrive?
Usually the testing period is on the 6th or 7th day. So that's why it's very important. We're meeting tomorrow, Wednesday, with Department of Health, of course, Department of Foreign Affairs, and the other government agencies, including the health experts, because we have now more and more studies about fully vaccinated individuals. Yes, it's true that you are protected, but then we want to see that if it can be shortened, because other countries are already shortening it. In Hong Kong, it's already also down to 7 days, but from certain countries, from low-risk countries, and they test about 3 times to make sure that if they're finally released. So iba-iba, we're really monitoring all the different ASEAN countries. But the point is, it's quite difficult, especially, let's say, for OFWs. When they come home, they want to visit their families. Tapos naka-quarantine sila ng 10 araw. Kawawa naman sila, di ba?
Masakit sa bulsa.
Masakit. Although for OFWs, nagbabayad yung OWA. But
yes,
Still, yung time with their families, yun yung kawawa. So, you know, the Department of Tourism, we have to continually look for ways. Of course, safety is always, we cannot compromise health and safety. But we also have to check the OFWs, our balikbayans, kung fully vaccinated. And we know we have more and more studies naman. And other countries naman are, you know, lessening the quarantine days. So why can't we also take a look at it?
Yeah.
So that's what we mean. In Thailand, right now, it's 7 days for fully vaccinated. But they're planning, I think their target is July. For,
okay,
let's say, Phuket. Let's say they are able to vaccinate 70% in Phuket. They will be accepting fully vaccinated. Tapos kung vaccinated na 70%, no more quarantine.
Oo.
But of course, those are just targets. We're always monitoring what other countries are doing. But right now, the norm is, at least in Asia, for fully vaccinated, at least for Thailand, it's down to 7 days. But of course, you know, this will be still a discussion. I mean, the Department of Tourism, now we gave that proposal, but we still have to discuss this with the health experts and the Department of Health.
Okay, I'm curious what you said in Hong Kong, they are tested 3 times.
3 times.
But you know, Secretary Puyat, the period of testing when somebody arrives in Hong Kong and is fully vaccinated.
Oh, I noticed when they arrive, they're vaccinated. And I think,
no, I mean they're tested. So when
they're tested. They're tested.
Yes.
Yeah. I think I know. I'm not sure how many, what particular days. I know when they arrive, they are tested, RT-PCR swab, and then they're tested there's an interval of 3 days. Because before in Hong Kong, it was, I think they only reduced it to 7 days for certain countries lang. For fully vaccinated. But before, kasi the quarantine days is 21 days. Actually, for everybody else, it's 21 days yung quarantine nila. But then for New Zealand, Australia, and Singapore, they've already reduced it to 7 days, but testing 3 days. Alam ko when they arrive, they are tested. I'm not quite sure what days they are tested, but at least for that 7 days, they are tested thrice.
Okay. Now, in many countries, in some countries, it's still returning residents. They are not yet allowing tourists. Yeah. The United States is actually unique in this manner that they do allow tourists, right?
Yes, yes.
You don't have to be a Balikbayan. You don't have to go there on official business. The U.S. accepts tourists, whether vaccinated or not, right? Mm-hmm. So, ito sa Pilipinas, what are you proposing? Only returning residents or also tourists?
Actually, whoever is allowed. Right now, of course, we are accepting OFs, OFWs, and Balikbayans, which is our third largest market. But the point is we have to start somewhere.
Yeah.
And for example, for Balikbayans at our third largest market, it could be like a test. Like if the DOH, the other agencies allow to reduce to 7 days, at least diba, you know, it's not, you know, it's not 10 days. We can encourage more people to come to test at least. And it's not like we're the first. Other countries have been doing it. But of course, this will be, you know, discussed by with the other agencies.
Yeah, the Okta Research Group actually supports your proposal. And Father Austriaco says there should be some kind of verification mechanism.
Yes.
To ensure that the travelers were really vaccinated.
Yes.
How would we do that, Secretary? I mean,
yes, that's
do you
right.
remember it was very controversial in the past? Will we require a vaccination passport?
Yes. That's why it's very important that DFA is with us. And then we've been asking also the IATA. IATA is the largest organization for the airlines. Yeah. And they've already met with them about a few months ago. And they already mentioned to us that they have a way to verify. And I think about 82% of all the airlines is with IATA. So that's why nga, yun na nga eh, yung baka para hindi ma-fake. Yon. And in fact, in our discussion regarding the vaccination, people are also asking kasi around the country kung pwede daw kung fully vaccinated, kung pwede na raw to go around the country. Again, this is also going to be discussed. Kasi nga, I actually even mentioned, kung yung RT-PCR nga na pepeke, baka ito naman yung next na ipepeke para makapasok sa isang lugar.
Yeah.
So those are the things that... For foreigners, we have to discuss this with the DFA, with the Bureau of Immigration, with IATA, how they do it, how do we know that it's verified. And then for around the country, of course, this has to be discussed with the DILG, with the NBI, with the PNP, para hindi mapeke. So again, this is just a proposal.
Yes.
But then, you know, we have to start somewhere, Karen.
Yeah.
As we are vaccinating naman, we are fully vaccinating. A lot have been fully vaccinated.
So let's start first with the green lane very quickly.
Yes.
When are you seeing some kind of policy or decision on this, considering a bulk of the Balikbayans, I mean, will be coming from the United States because the rest really are OFWs coming back from countries where they are employed from. Pero yung mga Balikbayans are usually more or less U.S.
Yes. We're going to be discussing this initially tomorrow with all the other agencies. But of course, this green lane is not only for the Balikbayans. It's for all, including OFWs.
And wala pong pinipiling brand ng vaccine.
Wala pang pinag-uusapan kung anong brand of vaccine. So that, again, will be discussed tomorrow.
Oh, you believe that? Okay. All right.
But probably kung WHO approved. Yun. But then again, this is all exploratory. But we felt that we had to bring it up. Diba? It's like the elephant inside the room.
Yeah.
Diba? It's every day somebody, I don't know, texts me and asks me kung may ibang quarantine procedures if fully vaccinated. And you know, Karen, yung nakakalungkot, yung mga nagtatext sa akin, mga OFWs. Kasi di ba, they want to spend time with their families and what, 10 days, kawawa naman.
Uh-oh.
So at least it's there, but I will surely update you you'll as soon as we at least reduce ang quarantine days, and of course the goal is as we are more and more Filipinos are vaccinated, then maybe we could take a look at lessening the quarantine days. But as of now, we just want from 10 to 7 days at least.
Okay.
As compared to the other countries.
All right.